Good afternoon. My name is Alina Shotsova. I'm an immigration attorney from Brooklyn, New York. In today's Legally Speaking seminar, I would like to talk to you about what to do if you file for asylum and now you're married to a US citizen. Because immigration law has been changing rapidly within the past a year and a half. How we would approach this situation changed as well. Well, first of all, you need to know whether, that your actions will be different if you enter the country legally or illegally, and if you already had your interview and were transferred to court, or you have not had your interview yet. So let's take the situation, a very common one, where you had your asylum interview and the officer transferred your case to court, immigration court, and now you're in removal proceedings. But now you're also married to a US citizen. What are you gonna do? So in most cases, what you're going to do is, of course, you will try to get adjustment of status if you did enter the country legally. Why? Because it's easier than asylum. I'm not saying that you have to abandon your asylum claim. It depends on situation. Everybody's case is different. Usually adjustment of status usually is easier to receive. When you will not go for adjustment of status, let's say you have certain grounds of inadmissibility that will preclude you from getting adjustment of status, but will not preclude you from getting asylum. So this is something that you will need to figure out with your lawyer. But let's say ordinary situation where nothing else is happening in your case. What you're going to do is this. Your spouse is going to file I-130 petition. And the government usually, and the judge is going to give you time for that I-130 petition to be adjudicated, to be decided. And after that, you will be able to file for adjustment of status. Previously, 2 years ago, let's say, you would be able to close your case at that point and forget about the removal proceedings. But now, most likely the judge is going to keep the case and will decide whether or not you will qualify for the green card after your I-130 is approved. Why? It's because since you're in removal proceedings, USCIS or administrative body will not have jurisdiction over your case anymore with regard to your green card application. Only the judge will. And that's why the case will take longer and will have to be resolved this way. What to do if you are not in removal proceedings yet and your interview is still pending but you are married to a US citizen? Again, you will need to review the circumstances of your case with an attorney, but most likely you will file for I-130 and for adjustment of status if you're eligible together at the same time with USCIS. And once it's approved, okay, once everything is approved, you will inform USCIS that you would like to withdraw your asylum claim. That's going to be the usual route. If during this time you're called for the interview, then you will make a decision whether or not you want to testify or you would like to withdraw your case. But the point is that as soon as you marry, okay, and provided that you have a real marriage and your spouse is willing to sponsor you, you should file that I-130 petition. Because the longer it takes, the worse your situation might be in the end. Because the goal, of course, is not to be in removal proceedings, because everything gets much harder at that point. So that's about what you're going to be doing if you are married to a US citizen and previously filed asylum and ended up in immigration court. Of course, each situation is different, okay? So that's very important to know. Little things here and there can affect the analysis, so that's why you always have to consult with an attorney prior to acting and especially prior to giving up any of your applications that you are eligible for, like asylum. And you can read more about various immigration situations and what you need to do on our website, www.shotsova.com. Thank you.